As a child, I was always interested in animals and wildlife. I joined this biology club, and with this biology club, I had the opportunity to observe a lot of animals and their wild habitat. But there's also opportunities for us to work in the lab. The curiosity of a young mind, you know, wanting to see what's inside of an animal, that's what like kind of drew me in. And to be able to see the inside, you have to like dissect them, and then I happen to have the skill set to dissect. And as a young kid, when you're being praised of, oh, you're so good at dissecting animals and the surgical skills and all that, you sort of think that, okay, this is something that's my calling, like that's something that I should be doing for my career. So that's how I went into the field of biology. And then after I graduated from college, I decided to pursue my PhD degree, and then flew all the way across the globe to the United States. Like, it was exciting at the time because it was like, whoa, I got into this program, I'm gonna be studying these things, the dream of my life. And then the heavy schoolwork kind of just like took my mind away from like missing my friends and family. It was quite intense the first couple years. So I was studying cardiovascular diseases and the relationship between high fat diet and heart failure. So what we did is we fed rats saturated high fat diet, and then we surgically induced heart failure in them by ligating an artery in their heart, inducing heart attack, basically. My findings is only true in rats, but not in humans. And this opens up a big question, like, why are we doing this? Why are we using rats? And so I went to my thesis advisor, and then they were sort of like not fazed by it. I went digging even more and to find out that actually this is not an isolated incident. Like, most of the animal studies do not reflect human biology, human physiology. And so much so that 95% of the time when a drug is tested safe and effective in animals, it turned out not to be true in humans. So 95% of the time the drugs failed in clinical trials. And all these animal testing that we've been doing is just, I don't know for what. And that's when I got like really uncomfortable with my study. And then, but like I brought up this problem to so many people, and they're just like, oh, you know, like this is just how we do science. I was like, no. You know, I flew all the way here to study like science. This is not what I was expecting.
Watch her all the time.
We're gonna get so, I don't know, I feel
you're
like
gonna be at work watching her
all day.
It was amazing to get the letter to say I was accepted into the neuroscience PhD program. I mean, it was just, that's not something I ever thought could happen. I'm the first person in my family to go to college, to graduate from college, and the thought that I would be one day Dr. Emily and studying neuroscience, which just sounds so fancy. You know, going in every day to the lab, I just felt really important. I felt like, you know, science was this kind of, you know, they call academia kind of this ivory tower. And so, and I thought, you know, this was kind of something, okay, these are important experiments, and we'll use a few animals here and there, but it's for the good of science. When we were doing all this, I thought, well, this is important. You know, it's regulated. You know, you hear that from people who defend animal experimentation a lot, how highly regulated it is, and all the hoops that you have to jump through and the rules that you have to follow. I mean, really, when I got a chance to look at the big picture, the rules mean practically nothing. You can do anything you want to an animal, as long as you write even the most sort of specious justification for it. And it started to be really apparent to me that I wasn't doing this for, you know, a greater good, really. I wasn't doing it to cure any diseases.
It's okay, it's just me.
The point of me designing this experiment, which would use animals, was to get me my degree and nothing else, to finish out so that I could be Dr. Emily. I didn't think that that was worth it. I didn't even think, you know, me being able to get my PhD was worth what I had taken. All an animal has is their life. And I took that from around 200 animals. So it just didn't, I was like, I can't keep doing this. It doesn't seem right to me. Something's wrong with the system.
So one professor said, your job as a PhD student is to graduate. It's not your job to think about this. So like I wasn't getting any real answers as to how we can solve this problem with animal data not translating to humans. And I quickly realized that all of the senior scientists, they don't know the answer either. They've just been trained in using animals so long that they kid themselves into believing it, or they just sort of hold on to this last hope, like it will help humans somehow, someday. I was like in the middle of my PhD degree, and I had a dilemma. Should I keep on going? Should I leave? I took several months to decide on this, and I still don't know if my decision was right. But I decided to finish my degree because I thought with a PhD degree, I will have a louder voice and I will be able to help more animals. It was kind of a selfish decision. And it required me to continue to kill. And I think that's probably why I'm so emotional whenever I talk about this, because I haven't forgiven myself. And I don't know like how I can get over this. I think it's important to show people what animal testing does on your psychological well-being. Like human nature, we're not supposed to kill, you know? It's just, it's not natural, it's not right.
You know, having done animal testing, it's something that you just know is wrong when you're doing it. I mean, you're holding an animal who, you know, didn't ask to be bred, didn't ask to be put in a box and shipped to a lab, to be held in a cage, you know, injected and killed. And then when you add on top of that, the fact that it's something that we really could be doing better. We could be devoting our resources instead to developing more human-relevant models if we weren't just so stuck in the past and in the habit. If we could overcome that inertia, you know, we could fast forward to, you know, more discoveries and better protecting humans. What I thought when I first started was that there would be a potential to have a really big impact on human health. So curing diseases, making people's lives better and healthier. And I think what the general scientific community is coming to agree upon is that we're talking about human health in most cases. So we want cells that come from humans. We don't want to know what happens in a rat. You know, we know we can cure cancer in rats. Well, it doesn't translate to humans. We can use non-animal methods that are actually better than the animal tests that we've used in the past. They can be based on human cells, human mechanisms of disease. You know, we've advanced so much. The science has advanced so much. We've learned so much over the past decades. We can do better, and we should do better.
It feels, I feel kind of embarrassed to talk about what I did. I have this feeling like somehow I should have known better, even though at the time I really had no way of knowing better. You know, everybody in charge was doing all of this too. The message that you get is if you even start to question whether or not is the experiment that I'm doing, is that right in the bigger sense? Like, that's very taboo. You can't question any science is good science. We're going to learn something from an experiment, even if it's poorly designed, we'll learn something from it. And to me, the fact that when someone's suffering because of that, you need to take a step back. So this is my dissertation. It's the culmination of all of those experiments that I did in graduate school. And I just wrote a short dedication. I dedicate this body of work to those who gave the ultimate sacrifice. Over 200 animals, mice, and rats were euthanized in the direct collection of primary research presented in the following chapters. My major professor actually refused to walk me at my graduation ceremony. He said that he'd felt betrayed and it would be awkward for him to walk me across the stage. So I ended up just not going. I just didn't feel, I didn't want to make anybody uncomfortable, so.
Thank you all for coming. So at the end of the thesis, you do your dissertation, like that's a, like a written report, and then you do a public presentation for like describing what you've done. So I did my presentation. In the older version, I had a line that says, to all the animals that I killed, I'm sorry, I was wrong. But my thesis advisor at the time told me to scratch that line because he said, knowing my committee, it will affect your chances for graduation if I put that line in. And that was like, it's really her fault because like, the thesis, it's my dedication and I wanted to say sorry for the animals, but I didn't get to do that. I don't see the animals in the cages just some tools for like, gathering my data. I see them as individuals. They, you know, they have emotions. They feel pain. They suffer just the same way we do.
I knew I would never do animal testing again. So that was when I had to really rethink, what am I going to do with my life? I just spent, you know, a decade investing in this science education where I thought I'm going to go out and change the world and make a difference. And here I am with this degree and all this experience. And now what am I going to do with it? The lab was on the 11th floor. It's interesting to be back here now, 10 years later, and think about how much has happened since then and what I've learned and the experiences I've had. It's a great feeling to be able to reduce animal testing, replace animal testing, and also protect human health and the environment. I mean, this is exactly why I got into science. It's a win-win because I can save animals and do good science. It doesn't get better than that.
So I've gotten many companies, food and beverage companies to switch over. And then they have a policy in place now to say that they will not conduct, fund, or commission animal testing. Just in the last year or so, the animals that I've saved has surpassed the animals that I've killed. And that was rewarding for me. Like, I kept a tally in the Excel file in my computer. Like, every time I get a victory, I calculate like, how many animals that I saved. And I compare that against the animals I've killed for my thesis. And I'm now in the net positive now, so I'm like, it's getting better. Let's take a break. Let's wipe off the tears.
Now I am so proud of the work that I do. I really get a chance to not only still do science, but I get to work at a policy level with legislators and big decision makers. And I am really so, so proud of that. I love my job so much. And I feel good. I feel like I'm gonna be on the right side of history.